म्यूचुअल इंडक्शन, द फिनोमिनन ऑफ ईएमएफ इंड्यूस्ड, दिस ऑलरेडी आई थिंक आई हैड गिवन, करेक्ट? हेलो, आर यू रिमेम्बरिंग आई हैड गिवन दिस?
यस सर.
फिनोमिनन ऑफ ईएमएफ इंड्यूस्ड इन सेकेंडरी कॉइल व्हेन करंट चेंजेस इन प्राइमरी कॉइल इज कॉल्ड एज म्यूचुअल इंडक्शन. Phenomenon of EMF induced in secondary coil when current changes in primary coil is called mutual induction. So if N2 is secondary turn and Phi2 is flux per turn, so N2 into Phi2 is total flux. This will be M into current flowing through primary. Okay?
Yes, sir.
N2 Phi2 is flux linked with secondary coil. Flux linked with secondary coil. And I1 is current flowing through primary coil. Write this much. One more line you can write down. M is constant called as coefficient of mutual induction. Mutual induction or mutual inductance, like this one. Phenomenon of EMF induced in secondary coil when current changes in primary coil is called mutual inductance. N2 Phi2 is MI1, N2 Phi2 is flux into secondary coil, I1 is called current flowing through primary. Completed full?
no suggestive in last name. Done, sir.
Now we are interested in EMF induced in secondary coil. So according to Faraday's and Lenz's law, EMF induced in secondary coil is rate of change of flux associated with the secondary. So this is d by dt of m into current flowing through primary, that is minus m dip upon dt. What is m? Constant, na? Hello?
Yes, sir.
So if it is given, define mutual induction. So we can say secondary voltage is minus M into change in primary current. If dip upon dt is 1 ampere per second, then EMF in secondary is minus M. Thus, mutual induction is defined as EMF induced in secondary coil when current changes in primary coil at the rate of 1 ampere per second. Copy. What will be its SI unit? Can you tell if you are remembering? Its SI unit is Henry denoted by H. Am I after the lecture? Wait for 2 minutes. Hello, Amay. Amay, can you hear me? Kama, you are there in the afternoon batch, 12:30?
Yes, sir.
Acha. What I taught there?
So, right now we're doing wave optics over there, right?
Ah, correct, correct. But you understood what we did?
Ah, sir, revision ho raha.
Okay.
We did few numericals also today.
I did around 7 to 8 numericals, I think.
Yes, sir.
Acha. Yes, done, Paul. Yeah, can I clear this up again? Hello? Hello?
Yes.
What SI unit of self-inductance or mutual inductance is nothing but Henry. What was second unit? Are you remembering? Hello? What was second unit?
Yes, just think and say.
Yes, think and say.
Yes.
It is ohm second I had written, ohm second.
Ohm second I.
हाँ, ohm second. याद नहीं क्या ohm second?
हाँ.
तो ये भी याद रखो. Henry or ohm second is unit of self-inductance or mutual inductance. Now, derive formula for mutual inductance in solenoid. Mutual inductance in solenoid. Derive formula for mutual inductance in solenoid. See, iska formula sab rat ke rakhna because ye thoda naya term hai aapke liye. Suppose we have two solenoid. One is primary, other is secondary. Primary means where we pass the current, secondary we get the current. Hello?
Yes, sir.
Can I say flux link with secondary coil is directly proportional to current I1? Can I say so? So, iske saath jo flux link hoega, wo kiska link hoega? First wale ka na? Current is passing through primary, uska flux getting linked with secondary. So N2 into flux due to B1, that means primary, which is directly proportional to current, is getting linked with secondary. Therefore, N2 phi of B, B means magnetic, of first upon this current I1 is M or not? Because if I write M I1, I1 will come here. Hello? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Therefore, M, that means mutual inductance of second coil with respect to first. Dono ka same hai. Because we assume that they are overlapping with each other. So M 21 is nothing but mutual inductance associated with secondary due to current in primary. This is equals to N2 into flux of B. What is flux ka formula? Area into number of turns. Hello, flux is area into number of turns.
Yes, sir.
So it is area of A2 and field of B1. This is flux associated upon I1. Therefore, M is N2 A2 mu naught number of turns upon length mu naught Ni upon length into current I1 divided by I1. I1, I1 will get cancelled. Not followed? Hello?
Yes, sir.
So mu naught N1 N2 mu naught N1 N2 into upon A2 upon L. Clear this much?
Yes, sir.
Now, usually length L1, L2 is same because we have the coil wounded on each other. Number of turns upon length. Number of turns upon length. हो गया ये फॉर्मूला आ गया एम इज म्यू नॉट एन वन एन टू टू कॉइल्स का डिफरेंट टर्न इन टू एरिया ए अपॉन एल सो दिस फॉर्मूला यू हैव टू रिमेंबर म्यू नॉट एन वन एन टू अपॉन एरिया ए टू डिवाइडेड बाई एल कॉपी दिस फॉर्मूला फुल mu naught n1 n2 area a upon a2 by l both are same so whether you write a1 a2 it won't change the sum In case of self-inductance, it was N square. Here you write N1, N2. Same formula actually we are getting. Can I clear this full?
Yes, sir.
Now, transformer, which is the easiest part of the chapter. The next class I will start with AC circuit. In two lecture, we'll complete transformer.
Okay.
So, two lecture AC part will get over. Please forget all the formulas. See, in entrance, important is formula, not the derivation. Transformer. Suppose this is one device. Where we pass this alternating signal, we get output also alternating. That means AC remains AC. Either magnitude will increase or decrease. If increases, then it is called step up transformer. If decreases, then it is called step down transformer. So they can ask in exam, state the principle on which transformer depends, draw its diagram, write its construction and working. So it works on principle of mutual induction. It works on the principle of mutual induction. It produces alternating output voltage from alternating input voltage. So nature is not changed. It produces alternating output voltage from alternating input voltage, but of desired value. If output voltage is greater than input voltage, then transformer is called as step up transformer. If output voltage is less than input voltage, then transformer is called as step down transformer. Understood what is transformer? It is device which will convert yes, alternating voltage to alternating voltage, but of desired value. Jyada rahega to step up, kam ho gaya to step down. Okay? Right, definition properly. If output voltage is less than input voltage, then transformer is called as step down transformer.
Done, sir.
Construction. It consists of soft iron core on which two coils of different turns are wound. The coil where we connect the source is called as primary coil, and coil where we get output is called as secondary coil. Let N1, E1 be the number of turns in primary, and N2, E2 be the number of turns and EMF in secondary. Just draw this diagram. Shall I clear this?
Yes, sir.
Fali, yes, sir.
Construction niche dekh lo. It consists of soft iron core. Bounded with two coils of different turns. The coil across which input is connected is called as primary coil, and coil across which output is obtained is called as secondary coil. Right, this much. So diagram and construction asked this much you have to write.
Okay.
Shall I clear this also?
Yes, yes. Yes, sir.
Working. Let phi be flux per ton associated with both coils. Let N1, comma N2 be number of turns of primary and secondary coil. Let E1, comma E2 be the EMFs induced across primary, EMF induced in primary and secondary coil. Therefore, E1 is minus d phi 1 upon dt, which is minus of N1 d phi by dt, equation 1. Because phi is flux for one turn, for N1 turn, flux is N1 phi, N1 is constant, I have brought outside. Copy please till this. Yes, done. Did it?
Yes, sir, done.
So E1 is minus N1 d phi by dt. E2 will be minus N2 d phi by dt. Dividing equation 1 and 2, we get E1 upon E2 equals to N1 upon N2. This is actually working. Ratio of EMF is ratio of number of turns. Now case 1. Step up transformer. Output voltage is greater than input. Output means secondary voltage, input is primary. So I can say E2 upon E1 is greater than 1. So N2 upon N1 greater than 1. That means N2 is greater than N1. What is meaning of N2 greater than N1? Secondary turns are greater than primary turns. Okay. So when step up transformer, secondary turns are greater than primary turns. Case 2. Step down transformer. Your secondary voltage is less than primary. So E2 upon E1 is less than 1. Therefore, N2 upon N1 will be less than 1. So N2 is less than N1. Therefore, secondary turns are smaller. So step up, we got secondary turns are larger. Step down, we got secondary turns are smaller than primary turns. Both the cases clear? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
So by chance they ask, distinguish between, write 2 points of distinguish between step up and step down transformer. So first point I can say output voltage is greater than input in step up. Second, I will say number of secondary turns are greater. And for step down, output voltage is smaller and secondary turns are smaller. Okay. Yes, am I followed? Yes, completed writing?
Yes, sir.
Okay, everybody's done. Can I clear it off?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Two part rahe gaya iska transformer. Ideal transformer. A transformer in which output power is same as input power is called as transformer. That is, input power equals to E1 I1, output power equals to E2 I2. Therefore, E1 I1 equals to E2 I2. So E1 upon E2 equals to I2 upon I1. But E1 upon E2 is equals to N1 upon N2, we have proved. So from 1 and 2, we get E1 upon E2 is I2 upon I1 equals to N1 upon N2. The ratio N1 N2 upon N1 is called as transformation ratio. Say ulta ratio hai. It is not N1 upon N2. N2 upon N1 is called as transformation ratio. Last part, what is efficiency of transformer? The ratio of output power to input power is called as efficiency. It is denoted by eta equals to output power upon input power. This completes our transformer and EMI chapter. Next class onwards, we'll start with AC circuit. In this week itself, I will complete. So by Friday, we'll be able to complete two extra lectures. I think I will require.
Okay, sir.
Because two extra lecture, comfortably I'll be able to.
So, sir, my lecture would be on Wednesday and extra lectures or...
See, when theory you are attending, then along with this lecture, okay? If it is CQ, then you are usual, na? Wednesday, Friday, okay, and Saturday.
Okay.
I will tell you next when to attend. Wait.
Done, sir.
Okay. So that's all for today. We all will meet on Wednesday. 8 to 9 is comfortable to you all? Instead of 8:30. Yes, am I chale bhai? This will be okay.
Okay, sir. No problem.
So 8 to 9 Wednesday extra, not extra, regular lecture. Then Thursday, Friday, Saturday we'll have daily lectures. So in that we'll be able to complete full AC circuit. And current, have you solved full MCQ of this chapter?
Yes, sir.
Full.
Yeah, 10-15 बच्चों की ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा.
तो complete कर दो, फिर Wednesday बताना, फिर extra lecture रखता हूँ आपके लिए, उसका doubt solve. So this week में आपका EMI with AC circuit पूरा खत्म होना चाहिए, theory and MCQ.
Okay, sir.
And we all other students will meet at 8 to 9 on Wednesday. I may wait, 2 minutes.
Okay, sir. Bye.
Bye.